In the previous video, we have discussed the theory, the working of hydraulic pumps. Now, we will take up the numericals, the solution to numericals. November, December 2017. Question number 15B for 6 marks. 15B. The question goes like this. A double acting reciprocating pump, double acting reciprocating pump is pump of stroke 300 mm. Length of stroke is 300 mm. Okay. Stroke length is 300 mm. And piston dia is 150 mm. D is 150 mm. Okay. Delivery and suction head of 26 meters and 4 meters respectively. Delivery head is 26 meters. Suction head is 4 meters respectively. If the pump runs at 60 rpm n, find the power required to drive the pump with efficiency of 60%. Efficiency is 60% or 0.60. what is the power required, how much power we should give it, right? Here this is 0.3 meter, convert it into meters. This is 0.15 meter. Then this is the speed. Now we want P. The formula for P, that is power, is WQHM by efficiency. This is efficiency of the pump. This is the formula we have to use. You get the answer in kilowatt, provided we know all this. W, it is water. It is said it is water, so W will be specific weight. W is the specific weight of liquid. Because it is water, its value will be 9.81 kilonewton per cubic meter. If it is any other liquid, they will give the specific gravity. Specific gravity into 9.81 will give you the specific weight. Q is the discharge. Discharge of the pump in cubic meters per second. And HM is called the manometric head. Manometric head in meters. This will be HS plus HD, that is suction head plus delivery head plus losses if given. Now in this problem they have not given, because if they want us to calculate the losses, they must give the length of the suction pipe and delivery pipe, and also the coefficient of friction must be given. That is not given, so it will, that will be treated as zero, that is taken as negligible. It is only HS plus HD. This is efficiency of the pump. Now here we know W, we know HM, that is HS plus HD. This efficiency is known. We want P. So before we get P, we have to get Q. Now Q will be 2LAN by 60, if we want it in cubic meters per second. So this will be the formula for Q. 2LAN by 60 cubic meters per second. Because it is a double acting reciprocating pump. If it was single acting reciprocating pump, we will not get this 2, it will be LAN by 60. Now L is the stroke length. it is to be substituted in meters. It is given as 300 mm. You have converted it into meters. A is area of cylinder, that is pi into d square. D square means 0.15 square divided by 4. Divided by 4, this pi d square by 4 into n. N is 60 rpm. This gives me the discharge. Now take the calculator. 2 into 0.3 into 0.15 square into 60 divided by, I'll make 240, equals 0.003375 cubic meters per second. This is the discharge of the pump. Now, if you substitute that there, you will get the power. W is 9.81, Q is 0.003375 into HM is HS plus HD, that is 26 plus 4 plus 0, that is 30 meters. So you take it as 30 divided by, efficiency is 0.60, 60%. So this discharge multiplied by 30 multiplied by 9.81 divided by 0.6, that will give me 1.65 kilowatts. So this is the power of the motor which is required to drive this pump to get this much of discharge through that height. Next, let us take problem number 31 in the question bank. The problem goes like this. A centrifugal pump delivers water at 30 liters per second. Q is 30 liters per second. 30 liters of water per second to a height of 18 meters. That is HS plus HD is 18 meters. 18 meters through a pipe of 90 meter length. Length of pipe is 90 meters. That includes both section and delivery. 90 meters, and its diameter is 100 mm. If the overall efficiency of the pump is 75%, find the power required to drive the pump. Find the power required to drive the pump. Take F is equal to 0.012. If they have given these three quantities, it means we have to take frictional loss into consideration. They have given length of the pipes, both section and delivery together. They have given the dia of the pipes, and they have given coefficient of friction of the pipes. That means we have to consider the losses due to friction. This is a problem on centrifugal pump. Now this Q should be converted into cubic meters. It is 0.03 cubic meters per second. It is given in liters per second, divided by 1000 will give you that. Now the power, the formula for power is WQHM. Divided by efficiency. W is 9.81, Q is given 0.03, HM will be equal to HS plus HD plus HF, that is frictional loss in this case. And HF we know is FLQ square. We have already done it in pipes. FLQ square by 3D to the power of 5. So F is 0.012, L is 90 meters, Q is 0.03 cubic meters per second square divided by 3 into D to the power of 5. D is 0.1 meter, 100 mm, 0.1 meter to the power of 5. Now, take your calculator, do it. HF 0.012 multiplied by 90 multiplied by 0.03 square divided by 3 divided by 0.1 to the power of 5 equals, it works out to 32.4 meters. 32.4 meters. So HM will be equal to, now HS plus HD is 18 meters plus 32.4 meters. So this will be 50.4 meters. 50.4 meters. This is HM. Q is known, W is known, efficiency is known. If we substitute these values here, we will get, if these values are substituted here, we will get the power required to drive the pump in kilowatts. So P is equal to 9.81 into 0.03 into 50.4 divided by 0.75. I'll rub that also. This also I'll rub. Now, if you calculate 9.81 into 0.03 into 50.4 divided by 0.75 will give me 19.77, or I'll take it as 19.8 kilowatts. This is the power of the motor required to drive the pump. That finishes this problem. Okay. Now, one more problem we will take. We'll take one more problem on pumps. From the question bank. A single acting reciprocating pump having a bore, bore means die of cylinder, bore, D, bore of 150 millimeter, a single acting reciprocating pump of bore 150 mm dia and stroke of 300 mm length. Stroke is 300 mm, L is 300 mm. Discharges 200 liters, this is Q actual. Q actual is 200 liters of water per minute. Per minute. Neglecting losses, find theoretical discharge. Find theoretical discharge in liters per minute. He wants it in liters per minute. Okay. And find theoretical discharge in liters per minute. Coefficient of discharge, that is CD, and slip, percentage slip, slip of the pump. Percentage slip, usually it is given in percentage slip of the pump. So this is the problem. on single acting reciprocating pump. Now, we know Q theoretical for a single acting reciprocating pump is given by formula LAN cubic meters per minute, provided we put these in millimeters. This is 0.15 meter, this is 0.3 meter. So Q theoretical will be L 0.3 area pi into 0.15 square divided by 4 into N is not given here. We'll assume something like 45 rpm. We'll assume that into N 45. We'll assume it. If it is not given, we can assume it. Okay. Now, I'll do it with a calculator. So, I am getting it as 0.238 cubic meters per minute. He wants it in liters per minute. So you have to multiply it by 1000. So Q theoretical will be 238 liters per minute. Liters per minute. This is the discharge we should have got as per calculation. This is the discharge we are actually getting, right? So we got this. Now CD will be Q actual by Q theoretical, both in same units. Here this is also in liters per minute, this is also in liters per minute. So actual discharge is 200 divided by 238. That will give you the coefficient 0.84. This is the coefficient of discharge. It means we are getting 84% of discharge of what we ought to have got as per calculation. We are not getting 100%, we are getting 84% of the discharge which we ought to have got. Right. Here both it will have no unit because this is also discharge, this is also a discharge, both are in the same unit, so it will be a number. Then percentage slip will be equal to Q theoretical minus Q actual by Q theoretical into 100. This gives you the percentage slip. So 238 minus 200 divided by 238 into 100. So 238 minus 200 is 15.96%. We are missing out, or you can take it as approximately 16%. So this finishes the problem. This problem. Okay, so this is how the problems are to be worked out in pumps. Thank you, friends.